Hello friends, welcome to bestreadouts. Today we are going to see how to fit the plane of regression when we are given three variables which depend on each other. We will also see the concept of multiple and partial correlation coefficients. Now multiple regression. When one variable depends on two or more variables, the study comes under multiple regression. Now in this video, we are going to see three variables which depend on each other. So to use the information about the variables whose values are already given to predict the unknown variable is multiple regression. Now the variable which we know is dependent variable. Here we have two variables which are independent because their values are known, and a variable whose value is not known is dependent variable, which depends on the another two variables whose values are already given. Now this, as we are given three variables, it is called as trivariate data. So suppose our variables are called as x1, x2 and x3, which are interdependent. Now here we are going to see the method of least squares to fit the plane of regression. Why plane of regression? Because we are having three points. When three points join, we get a plane. So we are going to see the method of, or use the method of least squares to fit the plane of regression to predict one variable, which is dependent variable, which depends on remaining two variables, which are called as independent variables. So suppose we want to predict the variable x1, which is dependent, and we are using the information on independent variables x2 and x3. So that is, we are fitting the plane of regression of x1 on x2 and x3. So how to write the equation for plane of regression of x1 on x2 and x3? We write that equation as x1 equal to a plus B12.3 x2 plus B13.2 x3. That is called this equation as 1. Now B12.3 and 13.2 are regression coefficients, and A is the intercept of x1. To fit the plane of regression, now let us study some terms first. Rij is correlation between xi and xj, which is same as correlation between xj and xi, which is rji. So in short, Rij equals rji, which is correlation between xi and xj. For example, r12 is correlation between x1 and x2, which is same as correlation between x2 and x1. Note that R11, R22 and R33 are 1. As now, what is RII? Correlation between XI and XI, which is 1. I for 1, 2, 3. Now, in this video, we are going to directly learn the formulae which are required for the fitting of the plane of regression. That is, we are now going to see the theory behind how to get this formulae. Now, R11, capital R11. Is 1 minus R23 square. Capital R22 is 1 minus small R13 square. R33, capital R33, equals 1 minus small R12 square. Capital R12 equals capital R21 equals small R13 into R23 minus R12. Capital R13 equals capital R31 equals small R12 into R23 minus R13. Capital R23 is same as capital R32, which equals R12 into R13 minus R23. RR small on the right side. Now the regression coefficients which we are using in equation 1 are obtained using the formulae. B12.3 is minus sigma 1 by sigma 2 into R12 upon R11. B13.2 is minus sigma 1 by sigma 3 into R13 upon R11. Remember, when we are saying R, R are capital here. Where now, as we know, sigma 1 is standard deviation of x1, sigma 2 is standard deviation of x2, and sigma 3 is standard deviation of x3. How to get the intercept A? It is just by using the change of origin and scale formula on means, just like linear regression for two variables. A equals x1 bar minus B12.3 into x2 bar minus B13.2 into x3 bar. Another equations which can use for fitting of this plane are x1 minus x1 bar equal to B12.3 into x2 minus x2 bar plus B13.2 into x3 minus x3 bar. Next equation which we can use is x1 minus x1 bar upon sigma 1 into capital R11 plus x2 minus x2 bar upon sigma 2 into capital R12 plus x3 minus x3 bar upon sigma 3 into capital R13 equal to 0. So we have seen the procedure now to find the value of x1 based on x2 and x3. Similarly, if we want to find x2 using the information on x1 and x3, we use the plane of regression of x2 on x1 and x3, whose equation is given by x2 equal to a plus b21.3 into x1 plus b23.1 into x3, where obviously now x2 is the dependent variable and x1 and x3 are independent variables. Again, dependent variable not known and independent variable values are already known. Now again we will see the regression coefficients, the formulae for regression coefficients in this equation. Can we call this as equation 2? Let us call this as equation 2. In this equation 2, the regression coefficients are given, whose formulae are given as B21.3 equals minus sigma 2 upon sigma 1 into R21 by R22. R are capital. And B23.1 equals minus sigma 2 by sigma 3 into capital R23 upon capital R22. And the intercept of x2 is given by A. A equals x2 bar minus B21.3 into x1 bar minus B23.1 into x3 bar. Similarly, now third equation to find x3 based on the given variables whose values are known as x1 and x2. That is, we want to fit the plane of regression of x3 on x1 and x2. We write the equation for the plane as x3 equal to a plus b31.2 into x1 plus b32.1 into x2, where the regression coefficients are b31.2 given by minus sigma 3 by sigma 1 into R31 by R33, R capital, and b32.1 is minus sigma 3 by sigma 2 into capital R32 upon R33. And the intercept of x3, which is A, is x3 bar minus b31.2 into x1. It should be x1 bar. Plus minus b32.1 into x2 bar. Now the partial correlation coefficients. r ij point k is the correlation coefficient between xi and xj, obviously keeping the effect of xk constant or eliminating the effect of xk. So by notation it is correlation between xi point k and xj point k. Note that small rij is called as total correlation coefficient and small rij point k is partial correlation coefficient. So its formula is given by rij point k equal to small rij minus rik into rjk divided by under root 1 minus rik square into 1 minus rjk square. Obviously, above here and down ijk values are from 1 to 3, I not equal to j not equal to k. For example, r12.3 equals r12 minus r13 r23 whole divided by under root 1 minus r13 square into 1 minus r23 square. Remember, r is small here everywhere, correlation coefficient. Similarly, we can write the formula for r13.2 and r23.1. Now, we are going to use this formula to find the sums values. We are going to substitute in the sums. So, we will have a practice of writing the formula and calculating them. Now, note that the limits for rij point k are minus 1 to plus 1. That is, partial correlation coefficient lies between minus 1 and plus 1. Now, let us see the concept of multiple correlation coefficient. Multiple correlation coefficient, capital R, I point jk is correlation between xi and its estimate. Estimate we denote by cap. So, it is a correlation between xi and xi cap. So, the formula for I, capital R, I point jk equals under root 1 minus determinant R upon capital R I j k of course 1 2 3, I not equal to j not equal to k. Now this formula gets simplified to under root R I j square plus R I k square minus 2 times R I j into R I k into R j k divided by 1 minus R j k square. Now, for example, capital R 1.23, which is correlation between x1 and x1 cap, that is correlation between x1 and its estimate, whose formula is given by capital R 1.23 equal to under root small r 12 square plus small r 13 square minus 2 times small r 1 2 into r13 into r23 whole divided by 1 minus r23 square. Now this division entirely is under square root. Now note that the multiple correlation coefficient always lies between 0 and 1. Hence we are going to take the positive root of this. So r1.23 is positive root of the given formula. Similarly, capital R2.13 is correlation coefficient between x2 and its estimate, that is correlation coefficient between x2 and x2 cap, and capital R3.12 is correlation coefficient between x3 and x3 cap, that is correlation coefficient between x3 and its estimate. Now, by estimate, what do we mean? Estimate after applying the formulae for fitting the plane of regression and finding the answers. Friends, thank you for watching the channel Best Readouts.